Good morning everyone, welcome to Raj Malhotra's IAS. So guys, we are about to start the session. So let me upload the PDF first. PDF for today's session has been uploaded. You can download the PDF from our Telegram group. So Moni, Pooja, Subhankar, Gunjan, good morning all. So let's start the session. Let's see what exactly is there for us in today's newspaper. So drone, flying objects and toys banned in Jammu and Kashmir after the attack. Okay. So but yesterday I told you about one thing, that banning is not a solution. Okay. You cannot ban things. So you have to update your सिक्योरिटी अपरेटस. ओके, आपको आपकी सिक्योरिटी जो है वो बढ़ानी पड़ेगी. बैनिंग मीन्स यू आर यू नो अंडरमाइनिंग द पॉजिटिव आउटकम्स ऑफ द ड्रोन. ओके, जो पॉजिटिव्स हैं आपके ड्रोन के वो आप हटा दोगे यहाँ पे. इट्स ऑल टुगेदर अ न्यू इंडस्ट्री, न्यू एम्प्लॉयमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज हैं ड्रोन इंडस्ट्री के अंदर. सो यू कैन नॉट अंडरमाइन इट्स यूटिलिटी. ओके, बट द प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट हैज decided to, you know, ban this thing. तो अभी देखते हैं क्या इसके ऊपर आगे होता है. सुप्रीम कोर्ट पुल्स अप द गवर्नमेंट ऑन एक्स ग्रेशिया. ओके, सो नाउ दिस इज वॉट सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज सेइंग. सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज सेइंग दैट यू शुड हैव प्रोवाइडेड सम असिस्टेंस एक्स ग्रेशिया टू द फैमिलीज हु हैव लॉस्ट देयर लव्ड वंस. ओके, कोविड से जिन लोगों की मृत्यु हुई है उनको कुछ एक्स ग्रेशिया आप देना चाहिए. बट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिबेट हियर इज कम्प्लीटली डिफरेंट. नाउ सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज सेइंग दिस कि आप एक्स ग्रेशिया दे दो. ओके, सो दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम विद सुप्रीम कोर्ट. दे हैव नॉट इवन थॉट अबाउट फ्रॉम वेयर यू आर गोइंग टू अरेंज द फंड्स. ओके, फ्रॉम वेयर यू आर गोइंग टू अरेंज द फंड्स. नाउ सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैज नॉट गिवन अ थॉट अबाउट इट. दे हैव जस्ट मेंशन दैट ओके द एक्स ग्रेशिया अमाउंट शुड बी रिलीज्ड. ओके, एंड दे हैव रिप्रीमेंडेड द नेशनल डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट अथॉरिटी that they have not done their task what was expected from them. But I am asking this particular question from me, where are you going to arrange the funds? Paisa kahan se laoge aap? Okay, so even if the demand was like 4 lakh should be given to each families, this was the demand, 4 lakh to each families. Now if we go by the official data, so it is 4 lakh people who have died so far. Okay, so 4 lakh into 4 lakh, from where are you going to arrange the funds? Then how are you going to manage the other expenses like vaccination? वो पैसा कहाँ से आप arrange करोगे? So this is the very critical question and Supreme Court must have thought about it. So we have to still move ahead. देखते हैं इसके ऊपर क्या ऐसे बढ़ेगा. They have been given 6 weeks to fix the rules for compensation. Okay, so how government will proceed from here? It will be a really tough task for them. Okay, काफी difficult task होगा ये. So देखना पड़ेगा. एक्स ग्रेशिया का मतलब होता है जस्ट एज अ फेयर मैनर. ओके, नाउ नॉट इवन योर लीगल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, बट इट मीन्स दैट पीपल हैव डाइड, सो इट वॉज द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट टू प्रोवाइड देम सम फंड्स. ओके, मॉरल ड्यूटी आप बोल सकते हो. ओके, एक्स ग्रेशिया मीन इट वॉज द मॉरल ड्यूटी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट टू हेल्प द पीपल हु हैव डाइड. दिस इज द पॉइंट हियर. ओके, दिस इज द पॉइंट हियर. सो विल मूव अहेड नाउ, आगे देखते हैं. Now, Chhattisgarh excess deaths at least 4.8 times like COVID toll, whatever they are saying. Okay, so this is not important for us. We'll look into the election, no guarantee against the tyranny, says the CGI. Okay, the CGI has given some statements. We'll look into his remarks. Okay, what he has said. So he has said that like mere right of public to change the ruler every 5 years by itself need not be the guarantee against the tyranny. Okay, it means that you can still have an authoritarian regime. आपके अभी भी यहाँ पे authoritarian regime आ सकता है. We have seen that how Hitler was elected. Okay, Hitler was elected and later he turned out to be an authoritarian person. So he is saying that in 17 general elections held so far, the people have changed the ruling party or combination of parties 8 times. Okay. Which accounts for nearly 50% of number of general elections. In spite of large-scale inequalities, illiteracy, backwardness, poverty, alleged ignorance, the people of the independent India have proved themselves to be intelligent and up to the task. Now, CGI is pointing out this thing. Now, it is the responsibility of the people who are now in power, okay, who are manning the key organs of the state. So, it is their responsibility that they live up to the constitutional mandate. Now, this is the statement that they have said. They have said that people are electing, okay, they are casting their vote, their job is over. Now, it is also important, okay, for the people who are in power, that they run their country as per the constitutional mandate. Okay, so there is a famous statement that it is not the constitution that is failing this country, but it is the people who are running the constitution that is failing this country. तो जो लोग power में आके constitution चला रहे हैं उनको ज्यादा नुकसान होता है. Okay, so that's the point. Now CGI said that judiciary requires complete freedom to apply checks on the governmental power and action. The judiciary cannot be controlled directly or indirectly by the legislature or executive. Okay, so this is what they are saying. They are saying that the independence of judiciary is really critical for the, you know, democratic process of this country. Okay, without that, other arms, okay, वो बिल्कुल ही एक तरीके से authoritarian हो जाएंगे. They will start undermining the rights and the interests of the common man. Okay, this is what CGI is pointing out. So further he is pointing out that the amplified noise produced in the social media was not necessarily reflective of what is right and what the majority believes in. So he is saying that whatever is going on in social media, that is not the real picture. Okay, wo bilkul sahi picture nahi hai, and we know this, how these days social media, you know, there are fake accounts and all, how things are managed. Okay, so other than that, there is nothing much. So notice to Twitter over the pornographic content. Now this is what is happening right now. Okay, so day before yesterday also there was some reporting of the thing. Now again it is happening. Okay, so like this is how government is forcing these particular tech firms to follow the law of the land. Okay, and there is no harm in that. These tech firms should follow the law of the land, but the question here is that how are you framing these law of the land? Aap kanoon kis type ka bana rahe ho? Sawal wahan pe aake rukta hai. Okay, so that's the problematic thing. Government should have looked for some amicable way, thoda shanti ka rasta lete, but now they have also decided to confront them, and we have to see how things will go ahead now. Okay, so one thing is that like these supranational entities, supra in the sense these social media platforms, they have their presence in multiple countries. Okay, so they have the supranational entities, supranational identity. Now this fight is between the supranational versus the sovereign. Okay, sovereign state, government in power. This is the fight which is going on. We have to still wait. Kya hota hai iske upar? Dekhte hain. So we'll directly move to the editorial section. Seedha chalte hain editorial section ke upar. Now one editorial is like providing us the complete picture of how Communist Party have, you know, ruled in China. Okay, so how the Communist Party endures. Now this is what this editorial is mentioning. So like this is just for your learning. Okay, this is just for your learning. So if you are preparing for interview, UPSC interview, it might be useful for you. Other than that, how Chinese, you know, Communist Party it operates, it might not be important for your exam perspective. Aapke exam ke liye itna important nahi hoga. Okay, so let's look into this, what exactly this is saying. So one point he is saying that Chinese Communist Party's longevity is due to the large measures to its ability to sum up the lesson of the history and change the course quite drastically if required. Okay, so they are saying that why this Communist Party is still ruling. So basic the idea is that they have somehow managed, okay, the vision of the Chinese community. Okay, one thing is that right from the starting, like the rise of China and all, the Communist Party, it gave the identity, national identity, to people of China as they fought against the Japanese and later on the you know, revolution thing. Okay, so the categorical rejection of anything that could be interpreted as a dilution of national interest. Now, this thing is for sure that they don't compromise on their national interest. Okay, this is one of the reason why it has maintained its power, because whenever something happens, they will invoke the national interest. Kuch bhi karenge, national interest ka shor macha denge, and people will start following that. The present Wolf Warrior diplomacy in recent times has been seen against the backdrop. Okay, now we know that Wolf Warrior diplomacy, the basically Wolf Warrior was a movie, it was a film. Okay, and in that, like, it was shown that Chinese people, they have to be really assertive, aggressive to protect their right. And we have seen this thing, how China was aggressive in defending itself when there were some allegation related to COVID-19. So COVID, corona se related jo bhi sawal uthaye gaye the, uska jo hai Chinese diplomats bahut hi aggressively uska jawab de rahe the. That was the point. Okay, now there are some lessons from the Tiananmen Square. Now, lesson was that political centralization had inevitably come at the head of revolution, heels of revolution. Though CPC, both under Mao and Deng, attempted to balance it with decentralization. And then came the historical lesson of Tiananmen crisis. Okay, so there were protests, there were dissatisfaction among the people, especially in the students and the workers. Okay, so the demonstrations were crushed by a massive use of force. The lesson for Deng was that if China was to achieve its economic objective, it could not afford chaos. Okay, so shanti to maintain karni hi karni padegi. Now, stability was accorded top priority and the nation's energy channelized into the getting rich. Okay, so stability was accorded the top priority at that time. Now, as the ideology declines, the dependence on the organization in holding the country together increases. Now, in the present time, it is more visible because communist ideology ab nahi hai wahan pe. Okay, it is not more, no more a socialist state. Kafi capitalism wahan pe promote ho raha. So this has reached unprecedented level under the Mr. Xi Jinping. Like, you needed a stable, strong leader. Okay, and Mr. Xi has declared himself to be a supreme leader. We know this, that he is going to stay in power. Ab wo hamesha power mein rehne wale hain. This is the real picture. Okay, this is the real picture and the new picture. Now, this was also thing. Other idea was that you need a strong party state. Okay, now basically China is not a nation state, it is a strong party state, because people, they are also following the ideology of the party. Whatever party is instructing, people are following that. Okay, so this was the picture now. This was the picture. Now we know that 800 million people, they are out of poverty, and China is like still facing lot of troubles and is one of the most unequal societies in the today's world. Okay, and there are another challenges, environmental challenges, like border issues and all. So this is how some issues are still prevailing in China. So in this particular situation, the world has to, you know, understand one critical point, that they are not merely dealing with a nation state, but an authoritarian party state. Okay, jo ki apne civilizational culture ko revive karna chahte hain. Now that's entirely a different thing. It means that Chinese will remain adamant, they will not compromise, they will not give a room. Okay, वो अपने national interest के आगे आपको कोई room नहीं देंगे. So you have to think some innovative ways. Okay, जहाँ पे आप Chinese जो community है, Chinese population है, उनको जो है persuade कर सके. Okay, ये हमारे लिए challenge होगा. So we'll move next now. So an attempt to silence the film Fertility. Okay, now this editorial has been written by the Kamal Hassan. Okay, so he is mentioning about the changes in Draft Cinematography Act. Okay, so under this particular act, like section 6 of the Cinematograph Act, okay, so government has added another section 1, which is providing revisionary power to the government, okay, to direct the re-examination of the films that has already been cleared. Okay, jinko already certification mil chuka hai, clearance mil chuki hai. Now government will be able to re-examine that. Now this power has been, like, government wants to give this power to itself. Okay, so this is done predominantly with a view to empower the government to interfere and influence the independence of Central Board of Film Certification. अब ये आइडिया कि सेंट्रल बोर्ड ऑफ फिल्म सर्टिफिकेशन जो है उसको आप इन्फ्लुएंस करेंगे, उसको इंटरफेयर करेंगे. ओके, सो दिस अमेंडमेंट कम्स क्लोज एट द हील्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट डिसीजन इन अप्रैल 2021 टू अबॉलिश द फिल्म सर्टिफिकेशन अपीलेट ट्रिब्यूनल. कॉन्सिक्वेंटली द ओनली रिजोर्ट अवेलेबल नाउ टू एनी फिल्म मेकर वुड बी डिसीजन ऑफ सीबीएफसी इज टू अप्रोच द रेलेवेंट हाईकोर्ट. अब सीधा हाईकोर्ट जाना पड़ेगा क्योंकि वो ट्रिब्यूनल भी इन्होंने बिल्कुल अबॉलिश कर दिया है. ओके, अर्लियर देयर वुड हैव बीन अ ट्रिब्यूनल. अगर कोई किसी को ग्रीवेंस है भी चाहिए तो सीधा जाकर ट्रिब्यूनल पे बात कर सकता था. नाउ दैट ऑप्शन इज नॉट अवेलेबल. ओके, दैट ऑप्शन इज नॉट अवेलेबल राइट नाउ. सो दिस इज द न्यू डेवलपमेंट विच इज गोइंग ऑन. सो अदर देन दैट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड. ओके, नाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन 6. Now they have brought section 6 subsection 1, but this particular section has already been declared unconstitutional by the Supreme Court. This has already been declared unconstitutional. So how come government bring in the subsection in that? That's the first question. Other idea is that the way government is working, basically it wants to curtail the freedom of speech and expression. Because film fraternity, they highlight lot of issues related to bad governance, social evils which is prevailing in the society, and sometimes it makes things uncomfortable for the government in power. So aapki government in power ke liye cheeze uncomfortable ho jati hain, and like this is one of the reason why, you know, government wants to curtail the freedom of speech and expression, and that's the problematic thing. So like this is just a draft which is out for public, you know, comments. So dekhte hain iske upar kya development aage hoti hai. Other than that, like there is nothing much in it, we'll move to the next part. Now this particular portion is really important for you. Okay, India's 1991 liberalization leap and lessons for today, because it is important for your mains exam. Mains in the sense that it has been 30 years now, 30 years of reforms. Okay, so that's why the question can be framed that what have we achieved. अब तक हमने क्या अचीव किया है. देयर कुड हैव बीन अ स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड क्वेश्चन. सो मोंटेंग सिंह आलूवाला, दिस इज हिज इंटरव्यू. ओके, so he's pointing out really good points that what have we achieved so far. So he's saying that reforms were hugely successful, but a lot remains to be done. Okay, so we are still in the process of transition, and there are a lot of things which are to be done. So there are some questions and answers, and we will be covering those things subsequently. Now, how would you describe the evolution of economy since 1991? The first question itself. Okay, so he's pointing out that the idea to come out with the reform was to energize the private sector to accelerate the economic reforms. Okay, and we know that like over the time the private sector is now leading the role. Okay, wo ek major role play kar rahe hain. And if you see things in the longer time frame, okay, so average GDP growth, like it had remained 7% in 25 years compared to the 5%. Like usse pehle 5% chalta tha, now it has been 7% in 25 years. Okay, poverty has declined, growth has accelerated, forex reserve hamara ekdam increase ho gaya hai. Okay, so like some of the reforms begun in 1991, especially in the financial sector, and have yet to be completed. We are still going on. Okay, what have not been done so much is the health and education sector, which have been neglected till now. Inke upar major neglect aapka aaya hai. Environmental concerns have not been adequately built into the development strategy. This is one of the negative point that he is pointing out. Abhi tak ye sab nahi ho paya ki environmental concerns aapne apni development strategy mein nahi dale. Now a lot of the blueprint for liberalization was already on the table. Ye bola ja raha hai ki Narasimha Rao government, like when it took the charge, many things were already done. Okay, so he is pointing out this thing that private sector was not allowed. Now he is pointing out picture prior to Narasimha Rao government. Okay, what was the situation prior to Narasimha Rao government? Now he is saying that private sector was not allowed to invest in number of sectors thought to be critical for the development. The so-called commanding heights were reserved for the public sectors. Okay, so public sector ke liye sab kuch reserved tha, and we know that their performance was lackluster, bilkul bakwas performance unki thi. Now where the private sector was allowed, it could invest only after getting an industrial license. So there was license raj tha yahan pe. First thing was things were, you know, reserved for the public sector. Another point was that there was license raj. Okay, like you have to take license to do your business activity. Now over 860 items were reserved exclusively for the small scale producers. Yahan pe sirf small scale producers ke liye you kept 860 items. Now why it was a problematic thing? It disincentivized the expansion of a company. अगर कंपनी बड़ी हो जाएगी तो वह स्मॉल से स्केल सेक्टर नहीं रहेगा. ओके, सो इट डिसइंसेंटिवाइज द बिगर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ अ कंपनी. सो कंपनीज यूज टू मेंटेन देयर साइज एज लो एज पॉसिबल, जितना कम हो सके उतना मेंटेन करके रखते थे. ओके, सो व्हेन अ कंपनी इज यू नो लाइक लिमिटिंग इट्स साइज, इट मींस दैट इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू एक्सपैंड एंड इज नॉट गोइंग टू क्रिएट एम्प्लॉयमेंट. तो एम्प्लॉयमेंट वगैरह कुछ नहीं होगा वहां पे. दिस वॉज द रियल पिक्चर. नाउ इम्पोर्ट वर मोर स्ट्रिक्टली कंट्रोल्ड देन इन ऑलमोस्ट एनी अदर डेवलपिंग कंट्री बिकॉज इट वॉज फेल्ट नेसेसरी टू कंजर्व द स्कार्स फॉरन एक्सचेंज. सो इम्पोर्ट वॉज ऑल्सो कंट्रोल्ड इन योर कंट्री. नाउ कंज्यूमर गुड्स सिंपली कुड नॉट बी इम्पोर्टेड, सो डोमेस्टिक प्रोड्यूसर्स फेस नो कॉम्पिटिशन. डोमेस्टिक प्रोड्यूसर्स के लिए कोई कॉम्पिटिशन नहीं था. एंड वेन कॉम्पिटिशन इज नेट देयर नॉट देयर, इट मीन्स दैट देर इज नो इंसेंटिव फॉर यू टू इम्प्रूव. आप अपनी प्रोडक्टिविटी, अपनी क्वालिटी को इम्प्रूव नहीं करेंगे. एंड इट यूज टू हैपन लाइक दिस, ऐसा ही होता था. सो प्रोड्यूसर्स कुड इम्पोर्ट कैपिटल गुड्स एंड इंटरमीडियरीज नीडेड फॉर द प्रोडक्शन, बट दिस जनरली रिक्वायर्ड एन इम्पोर्ट लाइसेंस. So again, license was required, import license, and like license was, it means that power was in the hands of bureaucrats. Bureaucrats ke haath mein power hoti thi. There used to be corruption and all to get those license. Okay, crony capitalism वगैरह वो सब होता था उस time पे. Now finally, the import of technology was controlled and FDI was discouraged. Okay, ये भी एक समस्या. So you need to understand, like we were fighting all these issues and effort to liberalize Indian market. Okay. So even prior to 1991, some efforts were made in 1980s, but they remained incremental change. Okay, whatever we did in 1980s, the things were incremental in nature, thoda thoda ho raha tha. So by 1990, it was clear that drastic change was needed, and 1991 brought that drastic change. Okay, and P.V. Narasimha Rao, like he provided the political approval to this. Okay, because there was opposition within the Congress party as well as the left party, right party, everyone opposed it. Sabne opposed kiya. So they liked domestic liberalization, but they were against the foreign competition. Foreign competition unko bilkul bhi pasand nahi tha. That was the point. Okay, foreign competition unko bilkul bhi pasand nahi tha. And there are a lot of pending market reforms like labor and land reforms which are still pending. So he is pointing out this thing, the need for labor market reform was recognized at that time, but it was thought that we should first get the industrial, trade and financial sector reforms, baad mein labor market reform aap karoge. Okay, so land is another issue. Land reform is still pending, and problem with that is land is a state subject and center had like doesn't have enough on its plate. This is the reality. It's a state project. Lot of things depends upon the how states are going to implement it. Unfortunately, the resulting legislation introduced too many conditions. Dekho, land reform ke liye land acquisition law was brought, but it was brought with too many conditions. Okay, so that's why there was a delay. इसलिए delay हुआ है. बहुत सारी condition यहाँ पे लगा दी हैं आपने. वो law itself is ineffective now. Now India progressively lowered the import tariff from an estimated 57% to 8.9%, but this trend has reversed in past few years. So these days protectionism is increasing. Okay, you must be knowing this thing. Protectionism aapka yahan pe definitely bad raha hai. Theek hai na, ye point aapko samajhna hai. So this article is pointing out like, is it the reversal of the trend? Dekho, aap global supply chain ka part banna chahte ho, uske liye aap protectionism aapko nahi karna chahiye. Okay, you want to become part of the global supply chain, and why are you going for protectionism? Why are you closing your market? Why are you closing your market? Why are you increasing your tariff? Because countries will not invest in your country. Okay, and subsequently they will also treat you in the same way. Aapka export bhi yahan pe impact hoga. So Indian industry has legitimate complaint about poor infrastructure, poor logistics, time consuming trade procedure, which reduces the competitiveness. So you have to address all these things. Ye sari samasyaon ko address karo, infrastructure provide karo, logistics improve karo, jo bhi aapka procedure process hai wo improve karo. That's the way out to improve your competitiveness. Closing your economy is not the solution. Okay, aap apni economy ko band kar rahe ho, wo solution thodi na hai. So it also like he is like talking about a fear that once government signals a willingness to raise duties to help the individual product, it will encourage a flood of demands. Ab aap ek do products ke liye agar aap duties increase kar dete ho, so every sector of the industry will start demanding the same thing. Har koi same cheez demand karna shuru kar dega. So it is going to be a tough task for the government. Kitni cheezon ke liye aap import duty ke liye baat karoge, kitni cheezon ke liye badhaoge. Okay, so like the solution to this particular problem has been given by the Niti Aayog vice chairman Arvind Prangaria. He pointed out that instead of you know going separately on each and every particular item, we can move to an average duty rate of about 7%. एक एवरेज लेके आइए और उस एवरेज के अराउंड मेंटेन करके रखिए. ओके, सो दिस इज व्हाट ही इज पॉइंटिंग आउट. इट प्रोवाइड्स सम ऑफ द क्लैरिटी इन योर पॉलिसी. कुछ क्लैरिटी आपकी पॉलिसी में आएगी. ओके, एंड दिस इज द राइट अप्रोच. दिस इज व्हाट ही इज पॉइंटिंग आउट. ये राइट अप्रोच ये बता रहे हैं. अनदर क्वेश्चन वॉज रिलेटेड टू वाई इंडिया डिडंट जॉइन द रीजनल कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव इकोनॉमिक पार्टनरशिप. ओके, सो क्वेश्चन वॉज रिलेटेड टू दैट एंड इंडिया ऑप्टेड टू मूव आउट ऑफ इट. इंडिया ने सोचा कि हम इसको ज्वाइन नहीं करेंगे. सो फर्दर दे आर सेइंग दैट like this is not a good thing because government is emphasizing on look east and act east thing. Like look east or act east policy ki aap ek taraf baat karte ho, and India should have joined the RCEP. RCEP ko hume join karna chahiye tha. Now reason for that is why are we not joining? Okay, hume dar ye hai ki that Chinese products will be dumped in your market. Aapke yahan pe Chinese product dump ho jayenge aur ye cheez theek nahi hogi. Okay. Now, you need to understand reduction in tariff required under the RCEP was to be accomplished over several years. ये एकदम नहीं करना चाहिए था. ये थोड़े टाइम लंबे टाइम तक ये इंट्रोड्यूस होता. ओके, ये पहली चीज एकदम से नहीं होता, थोड़े लंबे टाइम तक ये इंट्रोड्यूस होता. दैट वॉज द पॉइंट हियर. ओके, दैट वॉज द पॉइंट हियर. नाउ अनदर थिंग इज दैट लाइक यू शुड इंप्रूव योर कॉम्पिटेटिवनेस. Instead of running away from this particular competition, आप competition से पीछे क्यों भाग रहे हो? आप तो अपने आप को competitive बढ़ाओ. That's the better solution. Okay. Now other thing is that like if China is you know dumping their product, okay, if there is unfair competition from China, the solution should be imposing the anti-dumping duty. आप anti-dumping duty लगा दो. आप import duty को लेके क्यों इतनी बात कर रहे हो? Okay. So this is what he is suggesting. Okay. Now another thing is that we should not that geopolitics is forcing major countries to reduce their dependence on China. Okay, India cannot expect to replace China, but it can reasonably expect to become a major player in non-China dominated supply chains. तो दुनिया डाइवर्सिफाई करेगी. मे बी दे डो नॉट इन्वेस्ट इन इंडिया. अदर कंट्रीज माइट नॉट इन्वेस्ट इन इंडिया, बट द पॉइंट हियर इज दैट इवन इफ देर इज अ non-China dominated ट्रेड, so in that also India can play a really important role and RCEP membership would help in that particular direction. Another point he is making that as far as the free trade agreement with US, Europe and UK, like we have traditionally preferred trade liberalization in a multilateral forum, but these days multilateral forums pe to negotiations nahi ho rahe hain. Countries are negotiating their bilateral trade. Apna bilateral trade wo invest kar rahe hain. So he is pointing out this thing that like we have to do this, हमें ये चीज करना पड़ेगा, and there are some contentious issues like intellectual property or bilateral investment protection. So we have to accept that. Okay, we have to accept that this is the new norm which is developing. Now another point is related to the jobless growth. Okay, so he is pointing out that like we saw fall in employment in agriculture. Okay, people are moving, shifting away from agriculture. It's a good thing. ठीक है ना, वहाँ से जो है दूसरी तरफ ये जा रहे हैं, तो उस लिहाज से तो अच्छा है. And if you see in totality, total employment actually increased. Okay, but over the time in recent past, there have been some decline in the employment. And like it was prior to COVID जो है employment में कमी आई थी. अब COVID के कारण तो employment जो है और कम हो गई होगी. This is the real picture. Okay, so like unemployment increased, we know this. The problem was most severe among the youth. Okay, so who experienced the unemployment of 18%? Now this is the reality. So you have to you know bring in some incentives. Okay, informal sector ke upar jo impact pada hai COVID ka, you have to address that. वहां पे आपको इस चीज को ठीक करना पड़ेगा. नाउ व्हाट लाइज अहेड. ओके, यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड प्रेजेंटली वी आर रिकवरिंग फ्रॉम द इकोनॉमिक क्राइसिस एंड व्हाटएवर कंट्रैक्शन वी हैड, हमारी इकोनॉमी उससे तो रिवाइव हो रही है. देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट इट. नाउ प्रायोरिटी नाउ मस्ट बी ऑन वैक्सीनेशन कवरेज. जितनी जल्दी हो सके आप वैक्सीनेट करिए अपने आप को और कंड्यूसिव एनवायरमेंट बनाइए, नॉर्मलसी की तरफ जाइए. ओके, आपको ये अश्योर करना पड़ेगा कि देर विल नॉट बी मोर लॉकडाउंस, की और लॉकडाउंस नहीं होंगे. So this is what is important. Okay, ये चीज़ यहाँ पे important है कि कल lockdown, जितने lockdown कम होंगे उतना अच्छा होगा, आपकी economy उतनी strong रहेगी. Okay, so this is what we have to work on now as a country. So ये चीज़ इन्होंने यहाँ पे बताई है. Okay, so we have discussed all these things. The other one also we have discussed. Okay, so Kamal Hassan, The editorial written by the Kamal Hassan also has been written. Okay. So we'll move to next part now. आगे चलते हैं, देखिए क्या होगा यहाँ पे. So here we'll move to next part. Now Center's digital agri proposal raised the concerns. Basically अभी research paper out हुआ है. Okay. Now there are some concerns related to data protection, you know, and consent, mismanagement of land records, exclusion of landless cultivators, and corporatization of agriculture. Okay, so these are the concerns which have been highlighted against the center's initiative to digitalize the agriculture. Okay, agriculture ko digital component leke aana chahte hain ye log, but still there is some opposition to it. Okay, वहाँ पे अभी भी ऑपोजिशन चल रहा है. सो दिस इज द रियलिटी एंड सम ऑफ द कंसर्न्स आर वैलिड कि यहाँ पे डाटा प्रोटेक्शन का अरेंजमेंट होना चाहिए, मिस मैनेजमेंट ऑफ लैंड रिकॉर्ड्स, वो चीज़ आपको एड्रेस करनी है. ओके, एक्सक्लूजन इशू है, वो आपको एड्रेस करना है. सो दीज आर वेरी मच वैलिड रीजन्स. ओके, बहुत वैलिड रीजन्स है. सो दिस एक्चुअली कंसल्टेशन पेपर वॉज पब्लिश्ड अंडर द इनिशिएटिव ऑफ इंडिया डिजिटल इकोसिस्टम ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर. ओके, आइडिया करके एक नई चीज़ लगाई है इन्होंने. ओके, इंडिया डिजिटल इकोसिस्टम ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर, दिस इज द इनिशिएटिव जो सरकार अपनी तरफ से लेके आ रही है. सो अदर देन दैट, गूगल रिमूव्ड 59,000 पोस्ट इन अप्रैल. नाउ लाइक दिस रिपोर्ट इज रिलेटेड टू द कंप्लायंस रिलेटेड टू न्यू आईटी रूल्स एंड गूगल इज फॉलोइंग दैट. ओके, सो अब बात ये हो जाएगी कि अगर गूगल फॉलो कर रहा है तो लाइक व्हाट्सएप को फॉलो करने में क्या प्रॉब्लम है. ओके, सो बट दे शुड रिस्पेक्ट द लॉ ऑफ द लैंड, दैट्स फॉर श्योर. Whatever is the law of the land, they should respect that. ये आपको करना पड़ेगा. And world over the debate is on. सिर्फ इंडिया में नहीं हो रही, बाकी जगहों पर भी ये हो रही है. And big tech firms should be accountable. This is what our external affairs minister is pointing out. He is pointing out that thing like they should have the responsibility in governance. Okay. So these days governance has become a really complex activity. आपके यहाँ पर governance बहुत ही complex हो गई है. Okay. So in that particular thing, like these big tech firms, they have an important role to play. Okay. And they should play that role as the security demands. Okay, security की demand के according ये हो रहा है. So we'll move next now, आगे चलते हैं. India flags the green pass issue. Now problem क्या हुई है? European countries, they are not recognizing the Covishield and Covaxin, no, jab people. Okay, they are saying that we don't recognize Covishield and Covaxin for the green passport. Green passport in the sense permission to travel in Europe. Okay. तो वो इस चीज को लेके अपोज कर रहे हैं कि हम रिकॉग्नाइज नहीं करेंगे आपने कोविशील्ड या कोवैक्सिन लगाई है. एंड इंडिया इज सेइंग दैट नाउ वी विल आल्सो नॉट अलाउ द यूरोपियंस टू एंटर इंडियन मार्केट. ओके, इंडिया के अंदर हम यूरोपियंस को भी अलाउ नहीं करेंगे बिकॉज दे आर नॉट यू नो लाइक गिविंग एक्सेप्टेंस टू आर इनिशिएटिव. सो व्हाई शुड वी गिव एक्सेप्टेंस टू देयर इनिशिएटिव, हम क्यों उनकी जो वैक्सीन है उसको एक्सेप्टेंस देंगे. सो टिट फॉर टैट चल रहा है यहाँ पे. वी हैव टू स्टिल वेट एंड वॉच हाउ थिंग्स आर रिजॉल्व्ड हियर. Talk should be done, okay? Ideally, बातचीत हो जानी चाहिए. Other than that, there is nothing much, कुछ खास नहीं है. Now, European Union may offer vaccine to Bhutan. As I told you, this was a major crisis, okay? First dose was given, first dose इनको दे दी थी इंडिया ने. Then there was a second wave in India. इंडिया के अंदर second wave आ गई, इंडिया के अंदर shortage हो गई. There was shortage of vaccine, okay? So now, Bhutan is like dealing with this struggle that how are you going to manage the second wave, second dose, okay? तो सेकेंड डोज जो लगनी है आपकी कोविशील्ड की वो उनके पास नहीं है. सो दिस इज द चैलेंज दैट दे आर फेसिंग एंड दिस वाज अ लेजिटिमेसी क्राइसिस फॉर इंडिया. इंडिया के लिए एक मेजर लेजिटिमेसी का ये क्राइसिस बन के आया था. इंडिया इज लाइक यू नो इज पोर्ट्रेइंग इटसेल्फ टू बी अ लीडर और लीडर जो है एक तरीके से फेल हो रहा है यहाँ पे. ओके, दैट वॉज द पॉइंट. अदर देन दैट देर इज नथिंग मच. ओके, कुछ खास यहाँ पे नहीं है. ओके, वी विल डायरेक्टली मूव टू द you know, next part now. Okay, this page is also not relevant for us. Now, current account deficit widens as the import revives. Okay, so one thing is that increase in import, it means that your economy is picking up. Okay, एक चीज़ तो साफ होती है कि जब आपका import बढ़ता है तो जरूरी नहीं है कि सारी चीज़ खराब हो. Your economy is picking up. Okay, so this is a really a good thing. ये चीज़ बिल्कुल सही है. So other than that, there is nothing much. कुछ खास नहीं है. We'll move to next part now. Domestic consideration always come first for Chinese Communist Party. Now this is one of the reason like to maintain their domestic stability. Okay, domestic stability को maintain करने के लिए they do lot of things, especially in border areas और India के against उन्होंने जो किया है गलवान incident and all, it has been linked to the you know reducing popularity of Xi Jinping. That Xi Jinping was criticized on the corona issue, okay, aur unki popularity bhi thodi kam ho rahi hai. So to you know divert the attention, they started this thing, okay, Galwan incident unhone kiya. To ye cheez inhone bataya ki like Chinese jo people hain, like communist party ke liye domestic consideration are really important, okay. So whatever international effort they are making, steps they are taking, that should be seen from the prism of domestic politics of China, okay. ये पॉइंट इन्होंने बोला है. अदर देन दैट देयर इज नथिंग मच. इजराइल सीक्स टू बिल्ड वाइडर टाइज अक्रॉस द वेस्ट एशिया. दिस इज व्हाट लाइक दे आर पॉइंटिंग आउट दिस थिंग. ओके, यूएई और बाकी कंट्रीज के साथ उनके वैसे भी टाइज अच्छे हो गए हैं. सो वी स्टिल लाइक दिस इज द डेवलपमेंट विच इज गोइंग ऑन. एंड ये कहाँ जाके रहती है? इफ इट इज हेडिंग टूवर्ड्स स्टेबिलिटी एंड ऑल, इट इज गुड. इफ इट इज अबाउट पावर पॉलिटिक्स, ये पावर पॉलिटिक्स है दैट देर इज एन अलायंस अगेंस्ट द ईरान, ये ईरान के अगेंस्ट एक अलायंस है, देन इट इज अ प्रॉब्लमेटिक थिंग. ओके, तब ये प्रॉब्लमेटिक है. अदर देन दैट देर इज नथिंग मच इन इट, कुछ खास नहीं है. ओके, सो दैट्स इट फॉर टुडे. थैंक यू वेरी मच.